Firstly, I would like to thank each one of you for joining this webinar on the Customer Connect, which we have started to connect with our partners to share knowledge amongst us. We all know the world is facing through a difficult time due to this corona spread, and all businesses have been affected because of that. AI has also taken several precautionary measures as prescribed by the government for the past few weeks to ensure safety for our employees, customers, and partners. We are taking all steps to minimize the disruption to business and to ensure smooth restart as and when the environment returns to the normalcy. However, let us try to utilize the time and resources that we have at hand and make more of it. We also hope that each one of you and your family are safe and healthy and taking all the precautionary measures which is outlined. So coming to the today's session, in today's session, we will cover high performance glasses along with the challenges what we face in processing for the same. And to tackle the same, we have with us Mr. Vinay Ojha, who is the production head for our Taloja processing unit and also the in charge for our new model development. He will take us through the nuances of the processing of high performance glass. He will also talk about the challenges what we face and how to mitigate all those things. But before that, let me take you through the introduction of high performance glasses. Then what are the high performance glasses, what AIS is having. So the session, if you have any kind of questions, you may post all your questions and we will take up all the questions at the end of the presentation. So beginning the presentation with giving the view of our organization. So AIS is the India's leading integrated glass company and first manufacturing facility for producing the complete spectrum of the glass for architectural as well as the auto segment. And we started in 1984. And now in 1984, we started with a single customer company, but now we have 11 plants across the country. And we have diversified our business, not only to the segment, but from automotive to architectural segment, as well as to the consumer glass for auto as well as architectural. So if we want to just cover the complete value proposition of AIS, so our value proposition is the strong presence in the entire spectrum from sand to solution. If you see from sand to car glass in the automotive segment and from sand to windows in case of architectural glass segment. So in both the value chain, we are present till the last mile. But most important thing is that what makes us unique as compared to our competition and what are the things what we do in the architectural business, which is class apart and which will help even you when you are pitching for our product to the customers. So these are the uniqueness what you can bring out. Is first is about the glass knowledge. We are not just using the glass basis whatever has been come as from the Western countries. We have done a lot of studies and basis that we have developed the product which suits the Indian climatic condition. In addition to that, we follow the key account management where we focus on the customer. So we have the policy of customer first where we harp on the customer relationship and we nurture that. In addition to that, we have the project management, which is a unique thing for the glass industry, where we, as soon as the any project which is awarded to us, from that time onwards, we take the complete charge of the project and we give the complete clarity of the complete project plan till the actual execution, as well as getting the customer satisfaction index, doing all the kind of reconciliation. So this project management gives the complete insight of the project at any point of time to the customer, and they don't need to run from pillar to post to find out a very basic information. So that is the unique thing what we have started, and you can get the feel of this project management. So you can ask for the sales team who is handling your account to give a brief about this project management. So this is a unique feature what we can actually harp upon. Apart from that, we have new product development. We'll show that in the last 1 year, we have developed more than 50 new products, which shows our capability of developing new product basis the customer's requirement. Apart from that, we do a lot of technology support. So these technology support is in terms of energy simulation. So in case of any customer who is coming up with any project and they are confused about what kind of product to be used. So with the help of these services, we help them. So we will go to these services, how we do that in detail. But before that, coming to the products, what are the different products? So I'll not go to all the commodity products like clear glass tinted. We all know that we have these products. But with the help of a strong supply chain, we are delivering different type of product for exterior as well as interior range. And because of our great understanding of the product need of the market, we are developing all these products specifically for the customer requirement with the help of our great R&D capabilities. So if you'll see here in the high performance glass range, we have hard coat as well as soft coat, both the range. In the hard coat range, we have Opal Trends. And in the soft coat range, we have EcoSense, SunShield, and Neo. Apart from that, we have a lot of specialized product as well. So if we come to the EcoSense range, which is a kind of umbrella brand for our high performance glasses. So EcoSense is basically divided into three parts, solar control, low E, and double low E. So I'm sure that most of you already are aware about these categories. And in solar control range, we have Enhance, which is a normal solar control glass. Then we have Edge, which is solar control and thermal insulation with low U value product, even in single glaze with a U value of 3.7 to 4.6. In case of low E product, we have Essence, which is a plain low E glass, and we have Exceed, which is a solar control low E glass. And in double low E range, we have Excel. So if you will see that, if you will compare, I don't want to do any kind of comparison here, but we have all the products what any of the competitors are having. However, the unique thing here is that if you'll go through the brochure of our products, what we have done, majority of the product what we have developed, all these products we have developed, looking at keeping the Indian climatic condition into the consideration. So that's why most of the product what we have developed, it is in the range of 30% light transmission to around 60% light transmission, which is considered to be the optimum light transmission. So what normally happens that there are some specific very unique requirement where people can ask for a very high light transmission product, and for that we do have few products, but that is specific to some specific requirement. But in large, we have developed all the product to cover a majority of the market requirement, which is for optimum light transmission, low solar factor, and optimum U value products, which is the requirement for the tropical climatic condition. So as you all know that India is divided into 5 climatic zones, but majority of that part is hot and warm and humid and hot and dry. So all these places you will be requiring glass with these kind of values. And that's why we always harp upon these technical services, which I'll show that how we perform those technical services in the later part of the presentation. But here when I'm talking about the product, so in product, one thing what we need to keep in mind is the fact that these products are developed specifically for Indian climate, not coming, as you know that we have a connect with AGC, we have a joint venture with AGC. And AGC is having a lot of high performance glasses, but we are not bringing those glasses in India. because majority of those glasses are developed in Europe, considering European climatic condition, where they require a very high light transmission product and optimum solar factor. But those kind of product may not be suitable. Those can be great product for Europe, but it may not be suitable product for India. And that's why we have not gone for these kind of products, and we have gone for the product which we have developed for the country. Apart from that, we have the special products here, which is fire-rated glass, AIS Pyrobel. So as you all know that the new norm which has come in the NBC, it talks about the integrity of and the insulation of 20 minutes right now. And EW120 is best suitable. If you'll ask me, best suitable product is EI120, but because of the cost, people in India are not yet ready to take these kind of product. But yes, EW120 is the product what people are normally going for it right now. So because of this NBC norm, the demand of this product has also gone up. Now coming back to the high performance glass, which is the core of our topic, as I was explaining during the product part, is what are the different criteria which decides that what kind of product to be used. And I'm sure that when you are going in and pitching for any kind of product, one or the others will definitely be asked by the customer out of these six different criteria: aesthetic, energy efficiency, daylighting, strength, security, sound insulation. The last three part, you all know that it is a function of the processing where you are a master in. But apart from that, daylighting, energy efficiency, these parts is slightly technical, and it can be checked only with the help of the energy simulation. So those energy simulations we cover in 4G solution, where we help in selection of the glass, different type of products, processing with the help of our channel partner, what kind of processing is required, and overall integration of the solutions, what we do. So basically what we tell, when I was talking about the uniqueness about our services, so what we do in this energy simulation services or any other technical services what we are providing, we take the brief from the client for any project. Suppose any project which is coming up, we take a brief from the customer. And then we understand the requirement from them, what kind of requirement which they have, whether it is for sound insulation, wind load analysis, energy performance, artificial lighting. And basis that, we run the simulation and we give the solution that, okay, what kind of products are suitable. So this is something the output looks like. So in the output, we do the daylight analysis, where how much of the daylighting which is coming inside the building, the sun path analysis, which is very important because that impacts the requirement of the glass for the facade, the overall climate analysis. And finally, after all these analysis, we run the simulation with different kind of products. And then we understand what will be the energy consumption for after using different type of product, and we recommend which product is suitable for this kind of project. In addition to that, we have initiated one more service, which is the glass visualizer. So it is a rendering services where we take the building design from the customer, and in case if they have shortlisted, say, 3-4 products, so out of these products, they want to see that how these products will look at the building. So you all know that currently what they do, they ask you to put the mock-up. And with the help of these mock-up, they select the product. But even you know that mock-up is not the true representative, which can actually give the visualization of how the overall building is going to look like. So the best case will be that I want to see that if I am going to use these products, so how my building is going to look with these products. So that's what we have started as the rendering services. So what we do normally, we take that 3D design from the drawing from the customer, and we select. So we have taken a basic example of two products. We select any of the product what they have shortlisted, and then we decide how the rendering will be done, because you all know that a same glass will look different in the clear sky, will look different in the cloudy condition, will look different in the night condition, and will look different in the complete cloudy or overcast kind of situation. And they will also look different when you are looking at the morning time and you are looking at the evening time. So you should also know that if someone is telling that this glass is looking different than what it was looking in mock-up, it is basically not because the glass has got changed. It is because the ambience has got changed. The parameter on which you are looking at the glass, that has got changed. So all these things are covered in that rendering. And once you do all these things, you can actually look at the same building by looking at different type of product. Now in this slide, if you'll see, the same product, let's take one product, which is clear platinum. The same product is looking different in the clear sky at a different time, and in the cloudy sky at a different timeline. So if you'll see here, so at the bottom, we are showing the time. 8 hours, 16 hours. So in the clear sky with clear platina, how it is looking in the morning and evening. But if you'll change the product to say blue, how it is going to look. So this will help the customer in understanding what kind of product to be selected, much more than basically what a mock-up can do. And in addition to that, definitely, if we are doing it, it will help us also to save the cost of mockups if we are able to convince the customer for going for the rendering. So apart from that, there are some list of the customers which I am not going through. So what we have also done is that we are using the technology to help our customers to enable them in using the glass intelligently. So here we have a different type of applications what we have developed, and apart from that, we are also developing some more new applications. So AIS World of Glass, basically it talks about the overall AIS product and experiences what you can look at. But there is one thing called AIS Virtual World, which is the VR gear. So it will be running only with the VR gear, where you can actually take a tour of the different type of product in the live, in the virtual reality. Then we have a glass simulator, which is a very unique tool. In the glass simulator tool, if you have any kind of building, you put the parameter as the input, and then it will run the simulation, and it will give you the outcome that how much electricity saving different type of glass can do, and it can suggest the type of glass which should be used. So this is AIS glass simulator, and World of Shade is for the lacquered glasses, where you can use different type of lacquered glasses and see how these buildings will be looking at in different with a different type of product. Apart from that, we are also coming up with the augmented reality softwares. So in addition to that, when I was talking about the rendering, so in the rendering also, we will very soon be coming up with a software which will, where you will actually be able to see a different type of building with the rendering, which you can do just on your mobile app itself. Apart from that, we have also put a lot of solution videos in our YouTube channel. So I would request you to go to our YouTube channel and subscribe, so that all the new developments which is happening, you can have the update of the same. And there are a lot of solution videos also we are posting there. One new thing which we have done and which is very interesting here is our own plant in Gujarat. So we have our own automotive plant which we have completely made on glass. So we have used a lot of glass here in the factory shed. Whenever you talk about glass in the factory, you will be thinking about glass in the mainly main office building, not on the factory shed. Because you'll think that, okay, factory shed normally will be of the PEB sheets, not only with the glass. So there are a lot of challenges which we also thought before we actually started conceptualizing it. But when we sat at the drawing board along with our green building consultant, we realized that we actually can make a factory shade with glass with a lot of added advantage what we can get. So we got the IRR, internal rate of return, or payback period of around 1.5 year. And also we were able to get the green building rating system of we have still not finalized it, but till now we are at gold, but we are harping to go for the platinum rating, which we are sure that we will be able to get here. So I would request that in case if you are really interested, you can go and check and have the factory visit of RFI. You will have a completely different experience. So I would not take much of the time in showcasing these already available in our website. And I will request Mr. Vinay Ojha, who is the new model development head, to take us through the overall processing quality requirement, which is going to be a very interesting topic for you. So over to you, Vinay.
Good afternoon, everybody. Hope so. You all are safe and stay home. So now here we will go to the explain how we will observe the quality and what kind of standard should apply for each and every kind of glasses. Whenever we are looking the building glasses or the other kind of glasses, then so many people are not aware ki what parameters or what is the criteria. So we'll go very in what kind of standards is applicable and the for the various products. So first of all, I will explain the glass processing. There is a three major products which we are calling the tempered product, lamination, and the IGU, which you all are aware. If we will go in next slide. So next slide we can see there is a standard we have mentioned which are the regular use, like ASTM C1172, and this standard is the specifically for the laminated architectural flat glasses. So ASTM E2649, that standard is for the majorly using in the whenever we are using the argon gas inside the glass, inside the IGU. So this standard we are following through the instrument to measure the what value we have to get, so we can identify there is a argon gas is available or not. Now the ASTM C1279, ASTM C104, these all are the standards which is applicable for the tempered as well as the laminated and the IGU standard. Now EN14449, glass, this glass is the laminated glass and the laminated safety glass. Actually laminated glass, we are so many times confused because laminated glass is using the automotive segment also. So in automotive, whenever the laminated glass is considered for the automotive, then testing parameter is something different, and there is a lot of tests. It's about the more than 20 tests. But whenever we are coming in the architectural process, then there is a test quantity has been very reduced. It is only 5 to 6. So we have to very selective ki which standard we have to follow for the laminated of the standard. Now we are going to EN1863 part 1 and part 2. It is also using for the maximum using. This is the for the heat strengthened glasses. So in this standard you can get the evaluation of the conformity of the product or the definition of the disruption and the other things. Majorly we are using EN12150. This is a very global and the universal standard which we are following in the lamination as well as the tempered product. In this is a very standard European standard, and this is very important. So all kind of defects and all kind of process parameters has been captured in this standard. So most of the manufacturers, we are using the EN12150 standard for the glass processing. The EN1279, part 1, part 2, part 3, and 6, these are the also standard, but these are very rarely used because this is a long-term test method. These standards are specifically designed for the European countries. Because we know in Europe there is 8 or 9 months, there is a very low temperature, in minus temperature. So there they are doing the test for the long-term test, like 14 days, 14 weeks. So these standards are applicable for their environment. Then our people are also in India asking if we need to comply the glass against these standards. But these standards are for the specific environment only. So we have to refer these standards on that purpose. So every time I will suggest, if you are going to select the any standard or any project, so first you have to go scope of the standard, because scope of the standard has been defined as per the country, environment, and the application. So that is the selection of the standard is very important whenever you are going to execute the any project. Now we are come on the ISO 12543. It is a very good standard for the lamination product, and it has been covered the most of the tests according to the applications and the product, and each are very testing, and it is a very good standard. So in automotive segments also, so many places customer is using this standard in spite of ISO 253 part 2. Then now we are coming to ISO 29584. This is the building glass solution, and it is a pendulum impact test. Means you can say ki, this is a short back test, one kind of. Whenever we have to install the glass, the person has been go and impact any kind of heavy impact, so glass will break or not. So that specific testing is done, covered under this standard. If we will go in the next slide, then here we are going to explain the some kind of terminology which you are seen in the various standards. So the purpose of this terminology, you have to be understand what exactly meaning of these requirements. So where so many times we are seen in the standard bending strength. So bending strength means ki every glass is very flexible and there is some bending capacity. So whenever you are putting the load on the glass, so how much glass can bend and at what level glass can go to the break. Like this is a bending strength. This strength is mentioned in each and every standard. But where we can use? This is the basic question. Where this kind of standard, this kind of terminology we can use? This kind of terminology we are going to use like when we are making the tabletop. Because in tabletop is a glass where we are putting the load on the glass surface. So in this kind of application, we can use such kind of parameters demand from the manufacturer, see what is the glass bending strength, or in say equivalent bending strength, apparent bending strength for the pattern glass. Sometimes you can see the glass is a variable patterns and the other things. So in pattern glass, you cannot ask this kind of parameter because this thickness is not even in the glass surface. So it is not possible any manufacturer can calculate the bending strength of the pattern glass. So that's why here we are using the terms of equivalent bending strength. So what I am telling you, standards, what kind of standards you are using, that is very important as per your project requirement. Then heat strengthened glass, a single piece of glass that you are heat strengthened, in simple terminology we can say, or mechanical terminology we can say, fast heating, slow cooling, that is the heat strengthened glass terminology in very simple language. When insulated glass unit, it is a simple EVA or all, and two pieces of glass separated by one or more spacer, hermetically sealed along with the periphery, mechanically stable and the durable. One more thing, in where we are using the aluminium spacer to create a gap with the butyl. Butyl is generally called the primary sealant. actually butyl application is only, it is providing the mechanical strength in between the glass with the aluminum spacer, not any more characteristic of the butyl to put the for the IG. So many times we are very conscious butyl application, but butyl is the main function. It is providing the mechanical strength in between the glass with the aluminum spacer. No, nothing else. Now the standard laboratory operator, every plant is having their own laboratory systems, and but the environment should be ambient temperature 27 plus minus 2 degree and the relative humidity of the 65 plus minus 5%. If we will go for the next slide. So here we will discuss the what kind of test will be applicable on which products. So if we are going the thickness and the dimensional, this is applicable for the each kind of product like Tufan laminated, heat and then insulated. But when we are going for the flatness, so in the flatness there is a 3 to 4 terminology. First, overall bore. Second, wave and rural waves, edge lift and local distortion. So these all defects we can measure in the toughened safety glass, laminated glass we will also consider, heat strength, but insulated glass, this will be not applicable, only overall bow will be, these are not applicable in the insulated glass. Then we are coming for the fragmentation test. This test will be applicable only the tempered product, but lamination and the heat, IGU and the HS, it will be not applicable. Fracture and adhesion test. This test will be applicable in the laminated glass. Fracture and adhesion test, in simple words, we can say ball drop test. In the tempered product, it is called the resistance to human impact and the 4-point bending test. But fracture and adhesion test is called the laminated safety glass. We are ball drop test. Now the 4-point bending test. This kind of test is basically used for the automotive glasses or the lower thickness glasses. See what is the bending strength, which we have earlier explained the bending strength. So this is related to that kind of product. Now the surface compression. Surface compression, we are already aware about that there is some stress in the tempered glasses, which is called the compressive strength and the tensile strength. So that we are measuring after the tempering, see what is the stress level. So based upon that decision, we can also identify the glass is tempering is proper or not, it is HS proper or not. Then after there is some test for durability. Durability test is maximum apply for the lamination product. That is a high temperature test, boil test and bake test. Whenever we are asking for the boil test and the bake test, so we are boil test, we have to take a glass, put in the 100 degrees centigrade water, and we will see after some time if there is a delamination or not. So that procedure we will discuss later on, next slide. Say humidity test with condensation, without condensation. So we are doing such kind of test if glass is going condensation or not. Now same condition test. The radiation test means what is the impact of the ultraviolet source when it is directly coming from the laminated glass. So we are measuring that kind of effectiveness on the laminated process. Argon gas level test and the light stability test, this test will be applicable in the insulated glass. If we will go for the next slide. So the standard, here we are, there is two kind of standards. One is very simple for the clear glass, and the another is for the coated glass. Here we are talking about the total of the coated glass, so we will go for the inspection standard for the coated glass as per BSEN 1096. In this standard, majorly we have to define how we will inspect the glasses on the site or during the making or in the floor. So there is so many criteria. So first, the detection of the defect. So definition of the detection of the defect, the defects actually by an observation of the coated glass in transmission or in refraction, and artificial sky or daylight may be used as a source of illumination. Means we need to check the glass as a diffuse light or in any place where the direct sunlight should not come. So artificial sunlight, artificial sky means it is plain emitting diffuse light with a uniform brightness and the general coloring radius or the higher the illumination of the lux level should be 400 lux to 20,000 lux. So 20,000 lux is not possible. So we are going to see the more than 1,000 or 15,000 lux. So we are trying to see these glasses in open environment. But when you are checking the glass in the open environment, that you should always consider sunlight should not come directly on the glass surface. Unless it will be, you can't see anything. So this will be always seen in the diffuse light. So daylight, diffuse light or the daylight emission is very important in the glass inspection. Condition for the examination, coated glass may be examined in stock size panels means you can coated glass, you cannot check in the sheet. Coated glass will be always checked after the cut size or it will be made to size product. Then after only we can check with the minimum distance of the 3 meters. If we will go for the next slide, here you can see the picture viewing distance. So light source is the back side of the glass, but not directly in the glass. All visual dimensions, you can see there is a 3 meter distance. As per standard EN1096, there is a 3 meter distance defined for the vision glasses. For vision glasses, and practically you can see only a 20 second of glass. If any defect, you can identify the 20 second within the 20 second in a glass, then we can say it is a defect. But we cannot directly say it is a defect. First, we have to see the defect on the glass surface within the defined system. Then we will go near to the glass and then we have to measure the defect level, or we can see the intensity of the defect level. Then we will go to check each and everything according to standard. Like you have to see the some kind of bubble or some kind of pinhole, but we can tell on this is the defect once it will be the beyond the tolerance limit. If pinhole is like 1 mm, standard is telling that 2 mm is okay. That means that there is some abnormality, but as standard this glass is okay. So this is a criteria ki how we have to check the glass. So many times people are very seeing the glass very from near, like 500 mm and the 200 mm, and then they have to identify. Then they have to do the circle. Then after he will go for the 3 meter and seen, and then I am able to see the defect. So that is not a criteria. So this kind of criteria will always create the some conspiracy between the manufacturer and the suppliers and so many things, and it will be always problematic. So this is always we have to avoid. Now if we will go for the next slide. Here you can see the what kind of defects in the soft coat glasses, or what is the criteria to pass or accept or not accepted. So there is a two picture you can see. One is from the coated side vision. Second one is a non-coated side vision. So whenever you have to see the glass, the vision will be coming, reflection will be coming accordingly. So you will go for the defect wise. Like one kind of defect is on the stain mark. Generally, stain marks is not allowed in anything, but it is not seen by the distance of the 3 meters. Then after there is pinholes or the set points. So pinhole, if pinhole is less than 3 mm, then it is more than 3 mm, then it is not allowed in any area. Before going to this, we will explain the main area and the edge area. Whatever the panel size, you can see in the picture, 5% of the height and the 5% of the length is the total length or height. That is called the edge area. In this area, the defect level is something different. Definition of the defect, pass and fail, accepted and not accepted is something different criteria. And the main area, which is called the vision area, that area is the called the very important area. So like acceptance criteria area for the defect is there to another. So based upon that, we have to define the category in the two terms, main area and the edge area. If pinhole is more than 3 mm, not allowed in any area, either it's main area or either it's edge area. But pinhole is in between the 2 mm to 3 mm, then allow if not more than 1 per square meter. There is a one pinhole can be allowed in one area, but it should not be one more than per square meter. Allowed if not more than one. Edge area is also same condition. Now we are cluster. Cluster main area not allowed because it will be creating the distortion one kind of. Allow as long as not in area of the throw of the vision. Any edge area, but it will not coming the any vision effect and the any other thing, then it can be allowed. Now the major defect, which is the more complicated defect, nobody taking the responsibility, which is called the scratch. Because nobody can accept that this scratch is going from my side. So scratch, we are defining more than 75 mm scratch in main area, not allowed. Allow as long as they are in the butt edge area, as they are separated by 50 mm distance. 75 mm scratch or more than scratch can be allowed. But in between the two scratches, there is a distance should be more than 50 mm or 100 mm should be there. Then after we can only accept the glass ki there this kind of defect we can allow. Less than 75 mm allow as long as local density is not visually disturbing. Less than 75 mm scratch is available in the main area, but it is medium scratch or the hairline scratch, or we can say it is not affecting the our vision point of view. So then it is acceptable. But whenever we are talking about the edge area, then it is allowed as long as density is not visually disturbing. The main focus is vision should not create any problem from any defects. So that is the criteria to mean the. If you go for the next slide. If we will go for the next slide. Next slide, we can see the distortion in the insulated glass. In today's scenario, this is a very big challenge for the distortion measurement in the IJU or in the installed glasses. So here we will explain my experience as well as the site conditions. We have visited the so many sites. So when we are talking about the distortion, so as per the standard, there is equipment required, which is the every processor and every manufacturer is having in their lab. Now the person should be fixed, glass is moving, and we are making the angles based upon that we are taking the decision. But when the glass has been installed at the site, so how we will check the glass? What glass is available at the site? So first method, we will hold the glass very straight manner at the 180 degrees angle. Now we will go 3 meters, we will make the 3 meter distance and we will see the glass to the perpendicular. Once after everything fixed, we will move our body 45 degree left and the 45 degree right. In the 45 degree left and right, if we are not able to see any distortion in the glass, you have to consider that if we are standing in the perpendicular position, we are moving the 45 degree left, we are moving the 45 degree right. If in this moment we are not able to see any distortion, that means this glass is okay. Yes, you can, you should be able, or you can see the distortion, but that angle should be more than 45 degree. If you are going to 45, you are able to see the distortion, means this glass is as per standard okay. There is no any problem, because distortion is always measuring against the angle. So that angle is defined. Perpendicular, 45 degree left and right, you can move. If you are not able to see any distortion, that means this glass is okay. And this is the standard method to check the glass at the site. Now we will go for the next slide. This is again here we are showing the how we will check the coated glass. So coated glass where we are going to check, then first we have to cut the glass, then the washing, then it will be the coming like this. Is this I am explaining on the plant side, see how we are checking the plant. Then after the washing only we are able to check the glass, but that glass can be also checked 3 meter distance with the 20 second observation. One more important point, so many times people are continue washing the glasses, then that means everybody, they are not inspecting the glass. That means they are trying to search the defect. So we have to inspect the glasses in spite of search the defect. So processing standard 3 meter distance, washing the 20 second glass, illumination should be more than 400 or 800. Actually in the general 800 to 1200 lux is very good lux. In automotive the level is in between the 600 to 800. Any glass defect should be verified in between the 600 to 800 lux. That is the procedure and that is shown Japanese standard. So we are always checking the all automotive glasses on that scenario. In the architecture we are going for the 1200 lux. That is a very good lux level, and that is also giving the feel like a diffuse light. So you can use the that kind of light 1200 lux, and when 1200 lux is not very critical, if we are using the 3 to 4 normal tube lights, that will be appear like the 1200 to 1500 lux you can create. So you can see another important point in this inspection method I will tell. So many times people are putting the glass very near to the light. So there is also a standard. Light should be backside of the 500 mm from the object. If your glass is standing one place, then more than above backside 500 mm backside, there should be light coming. Not direct light, it is a part side by side light. We have to create the environment like the diffuse light, not we have to focus the direct light. So that we have to also understand how background is much better if you are using the black background or the gray background. That will be give the exact vision or exact defect location on the glasses. Now if we will go for the next slide. The coated glass area, here we have to also mention the edge area and the main area. So main area, again 5% of the glass. In the coated glass, 5% according to the size, length and width, and the main area is the main area. So at each examination that I have already explained, not more than 20 seconds. So these are the basic criteria which we have to inspect the glasses and how we have to inspect the glasses. So many I am already explained standards which you are selecting for your product. That should be first you have to study the standard scope. What is the scope of this standard? Because so many standards has been made for the very specific countries, and the like there is one kind of standard which is called the NF 129. NF, this standard is made specifically made for the France. They are having some different scenario, so their standard is something different, their criteria is something different. So every standard is made very specific location wise. So before going to select any standard which is applicable in your project, you have to study the scope and the criteria and what kind of applications. Based upon that, if you are selecting the standard, then you will never get the product, any defective product at your site. This is my suggestion. Thank you from my side.
Thank you so much, Vinay, for such insight. So we have few questions which we have received from your site. So Vinay, the question which we have received for from Ameya is that sometime we get a stress level above 69 MPa for fully toughened glass. But at the same time, for the same sample, we may not get 40 more fragments or particles in the fragmentation test. So in this case, what should we do? Whether we should go for fragmentation test or the surface test, surface tension test?
We have to, for the tempered product, we have to go for the fragmentation test.
Okay, so even though the stress level is above 69, but if the fragment is it will not be
According to standard, the thickness is also playing the very good role. If glass thickness, you will see the glass thickness is more than 10 mm. It may be possible that you are getting the stress level is full at tempered quality, but you are not getting the fragmentation according to this. So, again, I am explaining. The fragmentation count is also there is some 2 to 3 criteria. If you are going, there is fragmentation count is the 50 mm by 50 mm square, it is also applicable 100 mm by 100 mm square. If we are breaking the glass and you are not getting the fragmentation accordingly, then you have to improve the cell size. If you have to take the 100 mm by 100 mm, then you have to count. And then count to be, you have to consider the 60. It is that question. So you can move it out.
Okay. There is two questions from Ms. Madhuri. First is some raw glasses, they show the distortion before the heat treatment. What is the acceptable limit for basically you have got the coated glass and you have not done any heat treatment like tempering or heat strengthened, but still you are getting the distortion. What is the limit for that and how you check that?
This major roller view distortion equipment is coming, and it is standard is the 0.5 mm, 3 mm by 300 mm sample, or 80 of the 300 by 300 mm. So 0.5 is maximum limit.
Okay.
Instrument, you can use the roller view distortion instrument is coming to the market. You can purchase and you can measure it very easily.
Okay. And the second question is, in between ASTM standard and EN standard, what is better standard for DGU testing? I think we have lost Vinay in between.
Hello.
Yeah, Vinay.
Hello. For the
yeah,
DGU,
Vinay. So the question is. Yes, Vinay, go ahead.
For the DGU, ASTM is better.
What is the reason? One or two.
ASTM is majorly covered the tempered as well as the laminated product. In the major testing,
so,
is coming whatever
so ASTM
like,
is more exhaustive.
So that is EN is majorly focused on the tempered as well as the laminated product. So for the lamination and the tempering, EN is best standard. But when you are talking about the IGU or DGU, then you have to select the ASTM.
And what is the distortion level which is acceptable? Okay, with this we have already you have answered. What is the surface abrasion mark in coating? And what is the root cause for the same?
Surface abrasion marks, like one kind of abrasion, if there is some kind of fogginess you are seeing the glass abrasion means something has been rubbed over the surface, so you are not able to see that very clearly from the glass from another side. So that is a sub rub, one kind of rub mark. And the root cause, it is majorly either the handling problem, or during the processing it can be problem, the any roller or any brush mark can be applicable over there. So that kind of handling issues and the processing kind of problem. We are talking about the in the IGU process. If that abrasion mark you are considered in the solar control glasses, so then there is an N number of reasons which can be created at the site also, like handling, because glass is all glass and the cement that mixing after some time you are going to clean the cement or the other things, then it will be create the some the abrasion mark on that surface. This is the problem in the site majorly. So whenever you are using the solar control glass at the site, you have always think if we have to cover the coating surface of the solar control glass.
Okay, so apart from that, one question which is by Advait is, what is the reason for automatic breakage of the glass after installation? So if you take that question, or may I answer that?
I will say something on this area.
Okay.
At the site, normally we everybody know that there is some NIS impact and so, but at the site, apart from that, there is n number of reasons that the glass can be break at the site. First, installation is the biggest part. How you have to install the glasses. Second, during the installation, if there any chip off, any edge damage, any heavy scratches are there, that can be also a part after some time glass can be taken. Then majorly more of the part, my everything is okay, but some kind of screw fitting, like this is my experience which I have seen during my working, some kind of screw fitting, that screw is continue going and hit the glass, but that is not directly penetrate the glass, it is just touch the glass, so pressure is continue coming on the glass surface. But whenever you have to see, then there is some minor space and gap behind. But later on, it can be possible glass will move, or the some theory of the compression, then it will be take. So many things has been depend upon the glass installation, framing, gap, what kind of gap you are giving. So these are the things. Rest, Mr. Sales will explain.
Yeah, so there are a lot of questions which have come from the first part of the presentation. First is EcoSense product, whether it is clear based or tinted based. So EcoSense products are coming into clear as well as tinted both. So mainly it is in tinted, it is green and blue. And apart from that, in case of some specific order, we can give this glass in bronze as well as gray tinted. So yes, this product is available in all states. And we have also received a lot of feedback that we would like to have one solution specifically for the products and to understand the product in detail. So we'll discuss, our team will discuss with you shortly, and we will organize a quick maybe 30 or 45 minute session on the product in detail. Then there is a second question which is about the comparison of our products as compared to the competition, whether we can get some kind of rating reckoner for it. So yes, we will be sharing that. And in case in the next session, which we are planning to do, in this session, in that session, if you would give the feedback, we will add that part also in the same presentation on the product. Third question, which Mr. Amaya has asked, with the decrease in U value, performance of the glasses increased. True. So at below, what the value of U value we need to consider for the glass in high performance glass? So Mr. Amaya, so for any kind of glass which we consider high performance, these are the glasses which is spectrally selected, which means the light transmission, U value, and the solar factor, all three are within the acceptable limit. So normally when you will go for a glass, specifically for Louis, the value will be in the range of 1.9, 1.7. However, you can still go below that, but I'm not sure whether that is required in India to really do that. And that's why the energy simulation software which we presented, that Andy, that what kind of U value will be suitable. So in my presentation, I mentioned that the U value should be optimum. It is because of the kind of climate where we are in right now. But yes, if you are in cold condition, you need to have a glass with very low U value, and that's because you want to make the complete building insulated. So apart from that, there is one more question on the product which I have received is whether we can do this energy production with the help of your product as well as the competitor product. So to answer that, no, we should not do that. Yes, if you can give the values rather than the product, we will be able to do that, because that value we can put in our energy simulation, and basis that we can do the simulation. Then from Advait, the question is a value of solar factor, which is important, U value or solar factor at the time of glass selection. So Mr. Advait, this is a very subjective question, I would say, because it completely depends on the climate. So for India, if you'll ask me, solar factor is more important as compared to U value. But in the colder climatic condition, U value is more important. But overall, I am saying that the solar factor and U value depends mainly on other factors like the orientation of the building, the place where the building is coming, location, at a window to wall ratio, what is the opening size, what is the passive designing, what you have considered. This is all the things. We actually come to a kind of performance value which is required. As a thumb rule, if you want to know what Indian type of climatic condition, solar factor is important. So we received a lot of more questions which because of the paucity of the time we are not able to take up. However, we will be answering each and every questions over email. And if you'll see, there is the email which is shown here as cmore@aisglass.com. So you can write back the questions at this email ID or the email ID of the salesperson who is in touch with you. So we will be more than happy to answer all your questions. And regarding the next session, we'll very soon be in touch with you, and we will organize a next session again. Till that time, be safe, be at home, and take very good care of yourself. Thank you, and we are signing off now. Thank you so much.